So I've already explained to you how you can overwrite a previous printed line in another video, but what about if you want to clear the whole screen, the whole terminal? Well, this is what I'm going to teach you in today's video. To get started, we need to import a few modules, sys, subprocess, okay? So to clear the screen, or rather the terminal, we're going to run a system shell command from within Python, okay? So just a side note, if you don't know what you're doing and you're a beginner, don't abuse this method, especially if you're asking the user for a command to run, because you could face security issues, okay? So just use this for what I'm showing you, okay? So let's actually print a few lines before, just to show you what we get after the call. Then an input, something like press enter to continue, or maybe to clear the screen, which is even better. And I'm using the input to stop the program until I press a key. Okay, basically until I press enter, because otherwise we wouldn't see anything. Okay, it would be so fast that we wouldn't see anything. Okay, then I'm going to use subprocess run, okay, and then the command to run, clear. I'm using clear because I'm on Linux, but if you're on Windows, you should use CLS. Then later on, we'll create a function that actually checks the user's operating system and uses the right command. So you don't need to check manually, okay? By the way, here I'm adding shell true, okay? On Linux, actually everything worked without this, okay? Which sort of enables system shell features. But on Windows, this is not the case. So I've decided to add it to both, you know, Windows and Linux. And so that we are sure it'll work. It'll always work, okay? But keep in mind that shell equal true could increase security issues. But in this case, we're not asking the user to enter a command, but it's sort of hard-coded. We're using like clear, CLS, and stuff like that. So we don't need to worry. But if you were to actually ask the user for a command, etc., shell equal true could be a little bit more dangerous. So be careful and read the documentation and stuff like that, so you're sure you're not doing something dangerous, you know, in terms of security. Okay, so then we're going to do something like print after, like that. And then we can do something like input, press enter to exit. And we can do like subprocess run, still clear, shell true. And that's actually it. So let's try to run it and see what we actually get. So Python, clear screen. So before, press enter to clear screen, enter. As you can see, you've got a new sort of screen. Then again, actually we've just cleared the screen, cleared the terminal, which is really, really cool. So now that we've understood how we can use subprocess.run, we can actually make the function that I talked about. So let's comment all of this out like that. Go down here. Okay, so def clear screen. Okay, so we can do operating system equal sys.platform, which returns the platform, the user's platform, the user's operating system. And on the screen now, you should see the platform value for each system, okay? So you can then use them accordingly. Then, once we have the operating system, we can check if operating system is equal to win32, which is used for all versions of Windows, okay? We can do something like subprocess.run, then CLS, shell true, okay? Then, for Linux, operating system equal Linux. And I think that this is the same for Mac OS, but I've never actually used a Mac, so I'm not sure, 100% sure. So you Mac users, let me know in the comment section down below if it's the right command, okay? So operating system is equal to Darwin, then subprocess.run clear shell true, okay. So now we've made the function, okay, and we can actually use it. So print before, as we did above, then the input, press enter to continue, and now we are going to use the clear screen. Then print after, and then input, press enter to exit. Now here, clear screen again, we call the function. Okay, so let's try to run this. So this is commented out, so we are actually using the function right now. Okay, so clear screen, press enter to continue, after, press enter to exit. As you can see, it still works. And now it actually checks the operating system and uses the right command for the right system, okay?